I'd say go down that way instead of this way for your first time, because this one goes down and then up over this big mound, which is a bit scary at first. And you'll find that front brake, like on a street bike, is bad, because in this stuff you can lock it up so easily and kind of, but it is good to practice a bit on this stuff. Actually lock it up and, you know, figure out where you can, yeah. You okay? A little more gas than you wanted on that one?
Yeah, I didn't really plan on hitting the gas when I came up there.
You okay? You didn't bang anything that...
Might have tweaked my thumb a little bit, but I don't think it's bad.
Okay.
It was more just sort of... being unaccustomed to that Superman position behind.
Did you launch off of here?
I came off right here.
Oh, okay. And just
Yeah, I didn't quite have my line set up, and then I thought I could just sort of ride this out on the side, and then I guess I slipped on the throttle and gave it more fuel than I intended, yep. So I just went blasting off this gear.
Yeah. Even without hitting the throttle on this stuff, it's pretty slippery. You'd find yourself sliding off it. So yeah, once you get on something like that that's pretty loose like this, you'd find yourself kind of... So it looks like you kind of went up, got some air.
Yeah, and then I landed right where your foot is.
Yeah, kind of came down and then... Picking the bike up uphill is always a tough one. Definitely heavier than a mountain bike.
Yeah, it was funny when I was cutting the con, I said, you know, I think it'll be...
That was good save. Yeah, I would start it up. There you go, perfect. Yeah. Yeah. Not a 26-pound dirt mountain bike. You know what? Once I get kind of worn out, everything gets a lot harder. You're physically, mentally starting to get worn down, and everything gets a lot tougher. There you go, yeah. Because if you get too far down, then you're really deep into a squat.
Yeah.
And it's...
I was just way too deep into the squat.
Yeah. And it's like,